नमस्कार, मैं हूं निवेदिता। दुनिया बदल रही है और लोग भी बदल रहे हैं, और इसी की वजह से लोग भी अपनी बात समाज के सामने रख रहे हैं, और इसी का नतीजा था मी टू मूवमेंट, जिसमें दुनिया भर की महिलाओं ने अपने साथ हुए गलत व्यवहार और यौन शोषण का जिक्र किया, जिससे पूरी दुनिया के साथ ही साथ भारत में भी तहलका मच गया, और इससे कई लोगों के चेहरे से सादगी और सौम्यता का नकाब धड़ाम से नीचे गिर गया। इसी के चलते सरकार भी जागी और पुराने पॉक्सो कानून में बदलाव करते हुए नए पॉक्सो संशोधन विधेयक 2019 लेकर आई और राज्यसभा में भी पास हो गया। पास होने से पहले इस बिल पर चर्चा करते हुए टीएमसी सांसद डेरेक ओब्रायन ने अपनी आपबीती सुनाकर राज्यसभा में सनसनी फैला दी। राज्यसभा में बोलते हुए ब्रायन ने कहा कि जब वो 13 साल के थे तब उनके साथ बस में यौन शोषण किया गया। टीएमसी सांसद ने बिल का समर्थन करते हुए कहा कि जब मैं 13 साल का था तब टेनिस प्रैक्टिस के बाद घर आ रहा था और एक भीड़ से भरी बस में जाकर बैठा। उस वक्त मैंने हाफ पैंट और टी शर्ट पहन रखी थी। मुझे नहीं पता कि वो कौन था, लेकिन तब मेरा यौन शोषण हुआ था। 13 साल की उम्र में हुए यौन अपराध की घटना का उदाहरण देते हुए कहा कि इस बात को उन्होंने अब 58 साल की आयु में सार्वजनिक तौर पर कहा है। ब्रायन ने आगे कहा कि समाज में अब पुरुषों को भी इस तरह की घटनाओं का उल्लेख करने में संकोच नहीं करना चाहिए, ताकि ऐसे अपराधों को रोकने में मदद मिल सके। टीएमसी सांसद ने आगे कहा कि मैंने तब माता पिता को नहीं बताया था। हमें लोगों तक पहुंचने के लिए इस मंच का उपयोग करने की जरूरत है। जितना अधिक लोग इसके बारे में बात करेंगे उतने ही बच्चे बचाए जा सकते हैं। हमें इस जघन्य अपराध को रोकने की दिशा में काम करना चाहिए। एक बात आपको और बताते चलें कि मौजूदा विधेयक में बच्चों के खिलाफ यौन अपराध के मामलों में 20 साल से लेकर आजीवन कारावास की सजा और रेयरेस्ट ऑफ द रेयर केसेस में फांसी का प्रावधान किया गया है। मूल कानून के अनुसार बाल यौन अपराधों की प्राथमिकी दर्ज होने के 2 महीने के भीतर जांच पूरी करने और 1 साल के भीतर मुकदमा पूरा करने का प्रावधान है। तो आप समझ सकते हैं कि बच्चों को लेकर सरकार और समाज कितना आगे बढ़ चुकी है, और ये सही भी है, क्योंकि जब तक जागरूकता नहीं होगी और कानून की जानकारी नहीं होगी तब तक अपराधी बचते नजर आएंगे। इसलिए सभी को एक साथ बच्चों के इस अपराध को रोकने के लिए आगे आने की जरूरत है, तभी इस घिनौने अपराध से आप अपने बच्चों को बचा सकते हैं।
डेरेक ओब्रायन
सर, आई स्टैंड हियर टू happily and strongly support this bill and also express my disappointment that there was an opportunity available in the next 2-3 months to try and slightly improve this bill and moreover use those 2-3 months, if this bill had gone to a select committee, to create a lot of awareness on this subject. All my esteemed and senior colleagues here have spoken about and spoken very eruditely about the punishment on offer. And I'm lucky today because along with the minister speaking, there is also the information and broadcasting minister who's here. I just want to make one single point. It is not about the punishment. I think we've all discussed the punishment. Let me just spend 3 minutes on one point, and that point is the prevention. How can we prevent this from happening? And where does it all start? Someone mentioned it starts on television channels, on Facebook, on newspapers. It's very clear where it starts. Sir, it starts in your home, in my home, and in everybody else's homes. It starts in our home. Because all the cases today which come to light, you say some mama touch kiya ya kaka touch kiya, that is how it happens. And this is what is availability. And then what do we do? And it's for boys and girls. And what do? We are told, aisi baat mat karo. And the child actually doesn't express herself. The only reason for making this intervention is I would like and urge more people, especially in public life, if you have been sexually abused or harassed as a child, please come up and speak about it. And the more MPs who come and speak, the more actors, the more actresses, the cricketers, and the more common people. That's how more families will get encouraged to speak about this. And that's what I want to speak about today, sir, with a lot of pride and sadness and hurt. But I think India needs to know. because my family knows that on a bus in Kolkata, as a 13-year-old, after doing tennis practice wearing short pants and t-shirt, I got onto a crowded bus, and I don't know who it was, but with my short pants and t-shirt, I was sexually molested. In the sense, someone pressed, and I'm giving you the explicit details, sir, not to, but reason enough for someone, some unknown man, to come and ejaculate at the shorts of this boy. Sir, I didn't speak about it. 6 years, 7 years, 8 years, till I brought it up once much later in my life with my parents. And that is the kind of way I urge all of us here across political parties. The Information and Broadcasting Minister is here. The minister who is bringing this bill herself has a great track record on television to reach out to people. We need to use this forum to reach out to people. The more people will talk about it, the more we start talking about it, the more children will be saved. Punishment, very good, let the courts do. Let's work towards prevention of this heinous crime. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, thank you. Derek O'Brien.
Sir, I stand here to happily and strongly support this bill and also express my disappointment that there was an opportunity available in the next 2-3 months to try and slightly improve this bill, and moreover, use those 2-3 months, if this bill had gone to a select committee, to create a lot of awareness on this subject. All my esteemed and senior colleagues here have spoken about, and spoken very eruditely, about the punishment on offer. And I'm lucky today because along with the minister speaking, there is also the Information and Broadcasting Minister who's here. I just want to make one single point. It is not about the punishment. I think we've all discussed the punishment. Let me just spend 3 minutes on one point, and that point is the prevention. How can we prevent this from happening? And where does it all start? Someone mentioned it starts on television channels, on Facebook, on newspapers. It's very clear where it starts. Sir, it starts in your home, in my home, and in everybody else's homes. It starts in our home. Because all the cases today which come to light, you say some mama touch kiya ya kaka touch kiya, that is how it happens, and this is what is availability. And then what do we do? And it's for boys and girls. And what do? We are told, aisi baat mat karo. And the child actually doesn't express herself. The only reason for making this intervention is I would like and urge more people, especially in public life, if you have been sexually abused or harassed as a child, please come up and speak about it. And the more MPs who come and speak, the more actors, the more actresses, the cricketers, and the more common people. That's how more families will get encouraged to speak about this. And that's what I want to speak about today, sir, with a lot of pride and sadness and hurt. But I think India needs to know, because my family knows, that on a bus in Kolkata, as a 13-year-old, after doing tennis practice wearing short pants and t-shirt, I got onto a crowded bus, and I don't know who it was, but with my short pants and t-shirt, I was sexually molested. In the sense, someone pressed, and I'm giving you the explicit details, sir, not to, but reason enough for someone, some unknown man, to come and ejaculate at the shorts of this boy. Sir, I didn't speak about it. 6 years, 7 years, 8 years, till I brought it up once much later in my life with my parents. And that is the kind of way I urge all of us here across political parties. The Information and Broadcasting Minister is here. The minister who is bringing this bill herself has a great track record on television to reach out to people. We need to use this forum to reach out to people. The more people will talk about it, the more we start talking about it, the more children will be saved. Punishment, very good, let the courts do. Let's work towards prevention of this heinous crime. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, thank you.